characters where we're actually doing things that were done in this image. And as much as possible, like going around the people, going around the Hashanahs.
No, we said we're Shabbos.
That's actually, so we used the mourning for this image.
You're not sure. But
the mourning, what we lost, what we lost. But Sukkot is a time when we can actually do, and that was a link. But by action to something that was done then, so we're connecting the whole set of when he came and he was conquering the places, he came in Tisha B'Av, and he saw Jews sitting on the floor and mourning the Messiah. And he said, what are they doing? He said, they're mourning of the destruction of the temples. How long ago was that? That was thousands of years ago. Still mourning? Such a people you can't destroy. They're so connected. Yeah, we have a lot to mourn. We don't have the Beis Hamikdash today. The Sukkot is that day when we're in such a high place that we're going into the inner chamber of Hashem. And even after the Beis Hamikdash were destroyed, the going around the Bima was taken away. Because now it was bad. It was originally bad as well. It was brought back. So we need to link ourselves, to link us to that. Connected to a time which was and which is going to come back. Not letting go of such a hard time. Connecting to it. It's not just a memorial service. Everything we do is living. It's happening now. It's a very, very special thing. Actually doing something. You know, davening is remembering. It's, instead of karbonas, so we daven. Instead of this, we do this. Instead of that, we learn the halachas. It's as if we did it. This is something actually that was done there. Obviously not the same. It's not the same. But it's, when you think about it, that way, it's a direct link, you know, that I'm connected to something like that. Yeah. Very, very, the whole Hallel was said on the time of the redemption. Everyone will realize. He said also on the time of their ultimate redemption. And now, it's the time of personal redemption. I mean, from our sins, we're starting a brand new page. So also the personal redemption. Look at all the psukim in all of the Hillel. David HaMelech, as if he was writing it now. He was writing it, he wrote it then, he wrote it, he wrote it. Everything that we go through is mentioned in the final.
And then we have one last problem. That's if that
you guys. Hillel was something that's throughout the generation. Jews held it. Wherever they went. Huh? In every situation. Because David HaMelech went through all the situations. And it gives him. Tell him as a double man talking to his
life. But then it's not half a mark.
Every situation. Hard time we say Tillim. Happy time we say Tillim. There's a Tillim for everything. What's the common denominator between what is Tillim? You have Tillim that talks about Yitzhar Amalas, the praise. There's Hallelujah and there's Then you have to know that Yan Hashem is so that times of pain. What's the common denominator? It's all a song. The Jew has a power to sing for everything. What is a song? A song is something that bursts out. That's how we hear the song coming out of someone's voice. But really, it's not just the voice. It's something that's first started internal. And you're so filled with that feeling. The second, the voice.
I just said a whole.
David HaMelech had a power, and he told us all to sing through him. Why was he? How do you have the power to sing?
The other guy didn't.
Because no matter what, you realize everything Hashem was working with him throughout everything. The person dreaming about his life. was showing him his wife and he was walking on the beach. And the good times was like sunny and nice, walking on the sand. And the hard times was dark. So the good times, he was on the sand, there's another pair of footsteps. He says, who's this for? He says, Hashem is walking, holding your hand. Then the sky starts getting dark.
Because
of the lightning and everything.
Yeah, because
and he sees only one pair of footsteps. He says, now you left me? Where are you, Hashem? Where are you?
Some kids
are like, oh, understand. Now Hashem is carrying.
Some kids.
Carrying
some kids.
Daughter of felt that.
What does that mean?
With Hashem.
I asked about half of them.
Leave me out of it. One little girl said, I want to say.
So what's that?
Little girl, how are you? You're not afraid?
I asked.
So he said, that man is my father. You afraid? Yeah, it looks shaky. It looks like I can fall. Maybe I slipped a little bit. My father's only there.
This hole,
All these things started coming out. He said, it's all for us to actualize for ourselves. You have one eye over here, one ear over here, one over there, one over there.
Once
60 times two. But see, people have that idea. God wants you, he's going to give you to a beat. That's what I'm saying. That's like the point. He wants to beat anybody. He didn't hit anybody. He was looking, he was watching. He's proud of him. He says, you do the right thing. We all do the right thing. No, it's not for you,
Priya. If there is no, then what's
he going to do?
But that's your cash. Otherwise, why are you asking
cash? He's proud of him. He's watching. He wants to be with you. That's
it.
He's here.
You said, which one
is it? The company.
That means the ISMO, yeah. I don't want to train. Has to make sense, it doesn't make sense. But which way is it going?
Yep.
You just said there is. You said which way is it going? There is. You just said there is one. Which way is it going? That's not what you said. Can you say that?
Let me just get back to the lunch.
Now this is going on.
Okay, wait. How long do you have? I don't know. You have to give me half of
it. Not how long it takes. Obviously, it makes sense. You guys say, oh, it doesn't make sense.
Okay.
But everybody does. But really, everybody does. But it's two different stories. Because really,